Hey guys, it's Tong. Welcome to another DOS game review. Today I'm going to play a game called Dark Sun, which was released back in 1993 by Strategic Simulations for DOS. And this game is based on the Dungeons & Dragons series of fantasy role-playing games. See, it's an advanced Dungeons & Dragons computer game, and it's a pretty good game. I played this a lot when I was a kid. It's RPG, of course, fantasy setting. Many different characters, there's many different areas to explore, lots of dialogue, and it's a pretty good game. And I'll show you guys some gameplay from it. Alright, so let's start out. It's Dark Sun Shattered Lands. I believe there is a sequel to this one too, but I haven't played it yet. I think Ravager of the Wastes, I think, is the second one. But the first one is Shattered Lands. It's... You can create your own characters. I'm just going to show you guys how that's like. So this is a little menu screen, and you can create new characters by doing it here. New. You can choose Cleric, Druid, Fighter, Gladiator, Preserver, Sonic, Ranger, Thief. You can choose all these classes. Let's see. You can save a character here and add it later, which is cool. But yeah, there's different classes you can take. You can choose, this is a male, female, this is a halfling, or a dwarf, this is a dwarf. Male elf, so that's elf. Half elf, half giant, which are generally pretty powerful. Halfling, which are like half humans. Moles, which are like similar to giants, but a little bit smaller. Thrykeens, which are giant insects, basically. And humans, of course. So, and you can die roll and choose your stats, just like on Dungeons & Dragons. You roll the dice and you can choose your stats. And you can see your spells, side disciplines. But anyways, I'm not going to create my own character because if you choose start game, you start out with some pre-created characters, and the pre-created characters are actually more powerful than the characters you can create, which is why I use the pre-created characters a lot. Okay, so this is the beginning of the game. You start in this arena. Yep. Okay, so you have some dialogue, and you're in this arena. Basically, you're in this arena for the first part of the game, until you find a way to escape. And once you escape, there's like a whole other world out there where you can basically do a lot of different things, and meet a lot of different people, and kill a lot of different monsters. Yeah, that's the first part of the game. First, you have to watch this defiler be killed. Okay, so that monster that you guys just saw is one of the most powerful monsters in this game. It's a Rampager. So that monster, even if you're a high level, it's very hard to kill. But we're not going to fight those kind of monsters yet. We have the beginning monsters first. The weak monsters, of course. Okay. So what you can do here is... guard, wait, or end turn. You can see what this kind of monster this is. It's a Slig, level 3. So that's the kind of monster. You can attack it with an arrow like that. Okay. Attack. Or just regular attacking. Okay. Since my Jericus, this guy is a half giant, he generally does a lot of damage. Yep. Okay, so Cermak, he actually should know some spells. Okay, so I have some spells I can use here. Cast spell, and once you level up, you can definitely get more skills. There's different kinds of spells you can use. There's Mage. You can choose like level 1 you start out with. There's like Psionic, Metabola, Telepath. And right now I only have a few spells that I know, so I'm going to use these ones. It's a Magic Missile. Of course not, it's very weak right now, since I'm level 1. So yeah, so she also knows some spells. Cleric, she knows some Cleric spells. Psionic. Magical Stone, Curse, Bless, Shalea, Psionic Blast, I can do that. Okay, I didn't do anything. So I'm weak right now, so I'm just gonna attack him. Once I level up, I can learn more spells and stuff. Okay, and I got some money. You can yell something back at the announcer. And this is the standard RPG dialogue screen. So since I yelled something like at him, I think he released more monsters on me. And Jericho, since I can do the best at fighting. And get some gold. Yep. To go back into my pen. So yeah, in this game you start out as a slave. So you're in this kind of gladiator pen, and you're stuck in there until you escape. Okay, so I'm not gonna say that yet. Since you start out as a slave, you have to be in your slave pens. I think in about 3 rounds, I can start to... Alright, so just going through the playpens. I can overhear a conversation here. I'm not going to talk to these guys right now. I think what they can do is help me escape later, but since I'm not powerful enough, I'll just wait for a bit. I'm just gonna rest. This is my little hut here. Recover all my health. Even check what's in the haystack. And this is the cool thing about this game, is that there's so many secrets in this game. Can do. Like, so many objects can be interacted with, and so many secrets can be found. Like, this girl here, I can talk to her, and I believe she has some kind of mental illness. Okay, right in here. Might be able to help me later on. Search through this haystack. Alright, I have to go back into the arena and do another battle. I think there's 2 or 3 rounds before I can escape. Right. go back in the arena to fight. Alright, back out for the second round. Pick up the money. The thing about humans is when they die, they leave a corpse, unlike monsters, which vanish. And then you can pick up some of their equipment. So you can see some of the equipment here. It's not very nice though. Nothing special. What do I have equipment wise? I have. So this is my equipment. I have the regular equipment here. So the thing about this is if you want, you can set someone as the leader of the pack. So I can select Kuchatik as the leader or Sumac as the leader. And I can choose which one is computer controlled or not. So I can choose he is computer controlled, she's computer controlled, and I'll just select Kuchatik as my leader. And I can do something like that. So when you go back in the game, then he becomes the leader right here, which is cool. And then in the battles, then the other two will be computer controlled instead of me. You can even talk to the slaves here. Yeah, see. You can interact with so many things in this game, which is really nice. Just tied up prisoner. Delirious man. If I get him some water, maybe it'll help me find something. Ooh, some shoes. I think the leader always gets the equipment, yeah. Okay, she can wear the shoes. Put that there. Okay, so just for the purposes of this video, in order to make it faster, I'm just gonna make myself level up so I can kill these guys faster and then show you guys a lot more gameplay. This is what happens when you level up. You can choose to learn a different spell, telepath, metabolic, or kinetics, or depending on your type of person, you can upgrade, enhance the existing spell to a higher level, or you can learn a new spell. For this, there's mass domination. This one will control a whole bunch of creatures, so that's a pretty good spell. The other ones are not as good. Disintegrate's really good. So you can learn some mage spells, like Glitter Dust, level 1 or level 2. Flaming Spear is fine. So I can learn Stinking Cloud, Mirror Image, Acid Arrow, Web. Web. Okay, the upgrade control body, that's a pretty cool one. Glitter Dust. Ooh, level 3 spells. Lightning Bolt. Full person, minute meters, that's pretty good. Fireball's good. Lightning Bolt, that's good. Okay, I'll do one more level and then we'll fight these guys. Just so they're a bit faster. Life tree. Share strength and hit strength. Fast domination. Level 4 spells. Level 4 spells. Charm Monster is really nice because you can get those to fight against you. Ice Storm is pretty nice as well. Green Powder, which is Ice Storm. That's a pretty powerful spell. Let's try Web. Just slow him down for a bit. They're stuck in that web. Not really necessary, just wanted to show you guys these spells. Some of them are pretty cool, have some pretty cool effects. She has nothing. Okay, they're dead. Here goes Scar. Alright, so now we can try to escape. I think after 3 or 4 rounds in the arena, then you can talk to this guy, Scar, in the pen, and then he can help you escape. So now to get out of the West Gate, should be lightly guarded. To meet an arena fight on the way out. Okay. Okay, so they're gonna come in the arena, and then we're gonna get out the West Gate. Alright, and then we can talk to these guys. I think they're also gonna escape. Knock on the front door, because then we'll kill them too. Okay, so they don't have any good ideas. So I'm just going to follow Scar's plan, and then fight in the arena, and then he's going to help me escape. So let's do that. Okay, so I'm guessing that. Yep, so I'm guessing that these guys are escaping now. This guy's escaping, so let's get out of here. Okay, west one, west gate. Okay, let's go. Alright, so we gotta fight our way out, I'm guessing. But that's okay, because I'm pretty strong enough. I can just give myself an extra level just in case. Level 5, yes. I have Wall of Force, Wall of Stone. I can summon monsters, so I can do like monster summoning, summon shadow, domination, which will like utterly control any monster. Pretty fun spells. Okay. Should be pretty easy. Let's try that spell I learned. What was it? Oh, I guess I can't put it right now. Cure serious wounds, that's pretty good. Dust clouds, protection, obscure. Minimeters, let's try that. Dead. Can take some stuff. I don't think it's anything good. Nope. Some daggers and stuff, whatever. Wonder if I can use the sword. Thank you. Awesome. So I can use the key to unlock it. Who's this guy? Dinus. Leader to that girl. Broken. Drop this one. Nice. Oh, okay. Just an enemy. Another key. Ooh, a nice sword. He's got a lot of stuff here. Maybe killing him was a good idea. and get a lot of stuff out of it. Wow. Good stuff. Got some good loot from him. Boombrigand. Chest armor. Obsidian Bloodwrath. Nice. Nice, that's worth quite a bit. Good. So along the way you can find a lot of good magical equipment too. That's worth a lot of money, some have a lot of special effects. So it's always good to kill a lot of bosses so you can find these cool equipment. Chest. Oh, here it is. It's a sewer exit here. I had to use that to escape. So there he is. Okay, open it, and then you escape down to the sewer. So yeah, So yeah, that's how you escape from the slave pen, and sorry that took that long, but there's other ways you can do it. There's actually multiple ways you can escape from the slave pen, but I just chose to do this way because you can find out a lot of different secrets and stuff just by, basically killing everyone. And then you can have the whole place to yourself and you can explore more, but there's faster ways to do it, yeah. Alright, this is part 2 of the Dark Sun game review, and I just escaped from my playpen, and once you come out of the sewer, once you go into the sewer, you're basically confronted by these rat guys, who you have to either pay money, or you can fight them, and I don't really care, I can give half the chips, but it doesn't matter, you can either give them half the chips, or you can fight them. Follow these guys. I have to talk to the master, the rat master. Nope, not him. Oh, here, Nest Master Chur. That's his name. Oh, okay. Basically, he just alerted the guards for me. What a nice guy. nice. I can finally leave the sewers. I believe there is a, yep. Alright, so I went online and found the word. This is a little copy protection thing here that they used to do back in the day to make sure that you didn't pirate this game. And they will occur in different parts throughout the game. It's really annoying, but this is what they did for copy protection back in the day, is that they hid these words in the manual and stuff, and you had to like actually own the game to be able to use them, but in this case we have the internet, so yeah. And look what we have here. Right when I start out, there's guys coming from me. Great. There you go. I don't think there's anything special in these guys. Okay, so this is what we have, an obelisk. And these occur throughout the game because... So what they do is that they can teleport you around different areas of the game, but you need to put gems inside it. So once you find an obelisk gem, which are usually like this emeralds and rubies and stuff, if you find one of these obelisk gems, you can just put it right inside, and then you can teleport to these locations later, which have the obelisk power. So that's a really cool feature of the game, is that their teleportation method is you have to find these gems, put them inside the obelisk, and then you can travel to that place. But each place has their own little gem, so you had to kind of explore, you're kind of forced to explore this world to locate the correct gems anyway. I think that's a nice touch. I think that's another hole, maybe in the sewer. I don't want to go back to the sewer. Okay, let's get out of these cornfields first. Alright, so now that I escaped out of the sewer and from the playpen, I'm out into the open world, and this is the main area of Dark Sun. This is where a lot of the quests are here, and you can find a wide variety of quests and monsters and items, equipment, basically a lot of different cool things here. Okay, talk to this guy, he knows his slaves. Okay, heal here. But yeah, there's like so many different areas, so many secrets in this game, so many like cool little side quests and stuff. This game is just amazing, I think. There's so many like different areas you can go to, different cities, you can travel. Visit this area. Sweat sands. And yeah, once I find like the obelisk gemstones, I can teleport between these different places too, which is really cool. occasionally you find like traveling caravans and stuff. You can buy merchants and items and stuff. You can buy from the merchants there, which is cool. Now this guy wants to enslave me. You either join us or you die. I speak to the Templar. I bring news from the city. So he wants to enslave me? I don't think so. This is kind of some kind of slaving rig. I'm getting out of that. But that's another side quest that's there. You can free those slaves. This is a city. This statue actually comes to life later, I think, after I do this quest for the city. I think it's related to fixing the mag. The mayor of the city has a problem or something. I had to help him fix a disease or something. I had to overthrow him, something like that. Okay. The mayor gets drunk, he's the mayor. So he's being controlled by an evil being. Wormius. Fight him yet, because if I do, so eventually I had to fight him, but I need to recruit all the villagers, and you know what, to fix this, the village, since this mayor, or controlled mayor, has control over this village, I need an army to help fight him. Collector, I'm under 2 pieces of the statue to make my collection complete. Basically, the pieces of the statue is to revive that kind of monster that you see in front of us. One is the east, and the other is owned by a druid. Bring him to me, keep my promise, okay. So this is this quest you can do for him too. If you bring him the statue parts from the different parts of the... from the other parts of their land, then he's gonna revive this monster in front of the city, and then I have to fight that monster as well, so... yeah. There's something in this well, I think. Look at this well. I can climb down this well, and then there's this underground cavern, I think. Yep. And the cool thing about this is that this underground cavern or underground tunnels connected from different parts of the game. So, like, in other areas, it may lead down to different parts of this underground area. And then there's actually a side quest here, too. The side quest is to reunite these two ghouls, who are, not to kill this one here. But there's two ghouls that live in here, and, no, there's one ghoul that lives in here that's searching for his long-lost beloved, and you have to, this ghoul, basically. Yeah, Aplos, that's his name. He was betrayed and locked in his own dungeon. Yep. The heart crystal, I have to find the heart crystal for him. Oh, Okay. He was betrayed by his king. So the guy he's talking about is another ghoul that's also trapped in this place who's trying to find his long lost lover, and you have to help him too. So there's actually two side quests here. Yeah, there's like two side quests here. One of them is to help this guy, the other is to help the other guy find his lover. I had to find his heartstone or whatever in a different area of the world. There's another ghoul here. Won't be able to get through this part. So the other parts of this maze is accessed by different parts of this game. So I have to travel to other areas and then find more of these wells or different hidden passages that will lead to the underground part. Yeah. See, that's the cool thing about this game. There's just so many secrets in there, so many secret areas, so many hidden side quests, like this underground passage thing here. And then this whole city has another side quest to it, which is to defeat the defiler that's controlling everyone. Who's controlling the mayor, who you had to control and defeat everyone. And, yeah. Okay, I'm gonna go to a different area. The side quest in this city is one of the coolest parts. Who's this guy again? Lumius. Oh yeah, he's a defiler. Yep. He wants to revive his little monster guy. Okay. Yeah, that's a pretty good quest, but I'm gonna try some other areas first. Show you guys more of this uniqueness of this game. Some more cool areas to explore. Oh, right, and this is a slave area. Every area has like its own side quests and stuff. That's the cool thing. It's like almost every area has a few different side quests that you can do. Attacking me. Nope, I do not want to confront them yet. Finally, okay, I have to do that little side quest here. Save everyone. I get some nice equipment out of here. Password for the camp is Dust Devil. Okay. Well, I guess I have something to say to the other guys. Dust Devil. Okay. Oh, this is like the Helllands. So yeah, if you go down here, there's another quest. But basically this is the Helllands, and this is what happens when you go down to the bottom of the map. Basically the bottom map, but there's another quest here I'm not going to do right now. But yeah, there's some... Actually, we can see what else is here for a little bit. Yeah, there's some like fire elemental guys here. Yeah, I'm not going to deal with fire elementals right now. I'm okay. Yep. Just wanted to show you guys this area. Pretty cool area. Together with these things, they're pretty scary. Fire eels, that's what they are. Yeah. They pop out with their little ugly heads and attack you. Really kind of scary. What are you doing? Speak to you later. Okay. I think we have another side quest here. Let's see what we can do here. Where's your leader? Come with me. Oh, I think I know what they're gonna do. They're gonna probably strip me of all my possessions. Yep. So I'm gonna try to escape. Probably have to tackle these guys again. Oh no, another battle. Alright. Sorry guys, but I don't want you to take all my stuff. Like Ice Storm, or even Mass Domination. Let's try that one. Mass Domination. Actually, Domination is just... It's basically a control, controls anyone. But it works on only one thing. So I'll use Ice Storm. It's a big effect. Loisa. It's an interesting one. There's some guys that wander around. Okay, this is another city that I arrived, Tekizil, which is one of the major cities in Draj, in Dark Sun. There's some crazed visionary in the city. Anyways, it's a cool place. You have an obelisk here, so you can teleport here if you have a gem you can put in there. There's a merchant here. You show me your goods. Sell that. Let's See, a lot of these objects, they have properties that you can use, so that's why there's this magical icon. Some things have some magical abilities you can use. Prophecy. Okay, I guess I have to talk to the visionary. I bet this guy is like controlled by something too. Controlled by some evil force. Just like the other city. Yep, so there's this other side quest you can do. This is actually one of the main quests, I think, is to build up an army so it can help this visionary fulfill his prophecy. I think. These things are called Dune Reapers. Pretty massive. Like giant mantises. Oh wow, that's a lot of people. Okay. This guy walking around, Sage. I've heard of you, you escaped from the arena. Okay, so you're just someone you can ask about things. So if you have any magical items you're carrying around, you can ask this wandering sage, I guess. It It's a wand that can detect metal. That's cool. Cool. So this is an obelisk gem. Get in this obelisk gem. So basically you put these in the obelisk and you can teleport to that location later. Yeah, and this is a metal detection wand. You can use it to see if there's any metals around you. You can see what kind of metal you want to look for. Yeah. It might be useful in certain quests or situations when you want to find a jewel. I believe this is the Elvish Caravan area. Motion Caravan. Yeah. This is a pretty cool area. You can buy and sell lots of stuff, of course. There's an obelisk here, so you can teleport here. Let's try that obelisk gem. Okay, so this is the obelisk gem I received from that wandering sage, and you said it should look here, right? Nope, I guess it's not. It's not the correct one. It's a different one. This one actually I can buy from one of these merchants. Let's see. Caravan Master. Look for her. Yeah, I'm okay. Not that interesting. Nothing special. They're like, I don't know what you call them, they're like rocks with four arms coming out of them. It's crazy. I'm gonna use dominate. dominating. Yep, it's charmed. I still have to kill him. Okay, fine. No, not that. Glitter dust. Blinding. Oh, there's another one. Okay, that's fine. Now my guy's blind. Not a very good idea. I think this guy has a Mystario as a pet. So, he can actually sell this beast to me if I have some salt. So if I have some refined salt, then I can actually get that Mystario off of him, which is pretty cool. But it doesn't help me that much in battle. So this cactus is another cool monster. One of these cactus things. Okay, let's charm monster again. Okay, it's another quest that I don't feel like doing right now. Okay, I'm gonna take him into Kiesel. I know where that is, but I want to go there right now. I had an obelisk and to teleport there. So if I go through here, it's another interesting area. Kill these guys first though. There we go, we can go in here. I think we can. There we go. These are called the worm tunnels. So this is another interesting area of Dark Sun. Is the worm tunnels, where you can find another defiler, another crazy sorcerer who's trying to control these people and trying to control them for his own evil purposes. that evil defiler, I guess, that I was talking about. He controls this whole place. And, yeah. I can fight a lot of these guys. It's funny because when the Drakeen died, they leave behind a human corpse. Even though they're insects. What are these guys? Like skeleton axe murderers or something? Yeah, that's that defiler, and he's looks like he's controlling all these babao, which I can't even hit. Well, anyways, I guess that's it for this area. I can't really go past unless I kill this guy, but I can't hit him. Okay, there should be a well here, and this well actually leads down into the underground tunnel that I told you guys about before. With the ghouls and stuff. And yeah, here we are. Here's where the ghouls are. I can talk to this guy. I'm actually not supposed to kill him, but... Yeah, this is the underground caverns I told you guys about, where you're supposed to save two of the ghouls. You have a whole bunch of quests to do. There's a special rock in the middle. This is another part of this underground cavern. I can read this, this diary. I think this is the part about that one ghoul that's trying to find his long-lost love. You have to reunite him with him, with his love. This is related to the spider caverns, which I'll show you guys in a bit. Yep. So this is the underground caverns, another part of it. Let's go back up here. So yeah, the entrance to the underground temple can be found in many different areas. Oh, here's the village leader, that's right. Show me the opening to the spider castle. So the spider castle is one of the cooler quests in Dark Sun, and I want to show you guys it because it's a really amazing quest. And the entrance to the spider castle is a secret. I had to follow this guy and he had to show me. Basically, it's right behind this rock right here. Okay, there. Then I can do it. Use this rock. Okay, now I can go in Spider Castle. There we go. So this is the spider entrance to the spider castle. It's a cave, and this is one of the cooler parts of the game. Because I have to kill these things first. Alright. Check this out. So basically, the entrance to the spider castle is through this underground tunnel. This is the underground cave. You have to go through the spider cave and get into the castle, and this is a really cool quest because the queen of this castle, who is a spider, is actually possessed, I think, and you have to stop her, or you have to stop the prince or something. It's either you stop the prince and kill the prince and help the queen, or help the prince and kill the queen, one of those things. But it's a really cool quest here. This is the dwarf here. Okay, so yeah, the prince is the one that's the good guy, but the queen is evil and he had to kill the queen. Yep, and the queen is like cursed and stuff, so you had to help him. Okay, so he's gonna help me. To help them end this curse, which is plaguing their queen, I do wear the special talisman. There, silk talisman. To wear that. Oh, this is a rope. Sorry, this is the talisman rope. Stepping on this thing will cause me damage. This thing is breakable, I think. This is a door. There. Once I kill that, there's a lot of different treasures here. Kill these things first. Take control of the monster from it. that. I need these later on for this quest. Yeah, so there's this golden star pendant and stuff. Yeah, it has to deal with this curse. Yep. If I click on this, you can see some messages. Okay. And I think the Spider Queen should be somewhere in the castle. This is the Fungus Grove. The ancient evil or whatever curse is inside somewhere there. Not gonna deal with that for now. Oh, fungus does damage. Okay, here's the entrance to the castle. Alright, and this is the Spider Castle. This is one of the coolest areas in the game, where you can solve the mystery of the cursed Spider Queen, and also you can reunite that underground temple quest as well, where you can reunite that ghoul with itself. You can do that all in this the same quest. And yeah, I don't want to finish this fight right now, but yeah, this is the Spider Castle. You can see just how big it is. I think if you go down here, there's actually another... Okay, yeah, there's these Wyvern guys. I think that's another quest you can do, is to do something for those guys. I think they're vultures, actually, because they're half man, half bird. Yeah, you can see just how big this castle is. Some ancient hidden symbols here. These are the bandits. Yep. And then that's to the second floor. So, yeah, this game, Dark Sun, is a really incredible game. Just because it's a really big game, there's lots to explore, there's lots to do, there's so many secrets, there's so many side quests, and small things, I think, that really make this game incredibly interesting. There's many hidden stories here, and a lot of things to do. So yeah, this is a lengthy review, but I hope you guys enjoyed it. This is Dark Sun. And it's a really good RPG from 1993, and I still have no trouble playing it today, because it just holds up pretty well. The writing is good, the story is good. a lot of good quests to do, and it's just a fantastic game. And subscribe to me, like this video, let me know if you have any comments about it. Thanks for watching.